In this short video, we will install the off-road phone mount in the Rivian R1T. This mount also fits the R1S model. This mounting base is designed to fit the screen bezel right here on the passenger side and symmetrically on this side on the driver portion. I'm filming this on the passenger side to give you a better view of what the steps are, but they are just a mirror version when you're looking at from the driver point of view. There are three easy steps. The first step is to open up the mounting base. So we're going to back out the screw such that the center portion of the mounting base starts to float and slide freely. This is also a good time to have a close look at what the mounting base actually is. It is a fully metal piece machined from aluminum and black anodized. It's got a molded rubber elastomer to protect the contact area, so if you ever have to remove this, you can do so without leaving any evidence this was ever installed. Well, the next step is to offer it up to where it's supposed to sit. If you run your finger behind your screen in the area of this recess right here, you will feel a series of slots. We're going to use this feature to hook onto using this center portion of the mount. So this is the hook that's going to go into the first slot. This is the portion that's going to rest on the back of the screen and provide ample support. So let's do that. I'm going to hold the mounting base like this with my index finger pushing on the sliding portion. I'm going to offer it up and I'm going to feel my way to the first slot. That's it. I got it hooked on. Now I'm going to use the other hand just to hold it in place temporarily. And using the L key, and that's my last and third step, I'm going to cinch down this screw to clamp this mount to the bezel of the screen. You will notice that the actual mounting base does not come in contact with any of the screen, the screen itself. It just clamps to the metal bezel. I'm going to cinch it down nice and snug, but I'm not going to over tighten. And once I'm done, I have a really secure integrated mounting platform for the rest of the off-road phone mount. Now that I've got the mounting base installed on the driver's side, let's complete the installation with the rest of the off-road phone mount. The rest of the mount comes with a coupling arm and a choice of a phone holder. We're going to start by installing the universal phone holder to show you how it works. To do this, back of the thumb nut to open up the arm, place the arm over the ball, and insert the holder into the other end of the socket. Now, just cinch down the thumb nut. And before you completely lock it in place, you can choose the position that works for you. So the arm gives you plenty of adjustability. And what I'm going to choose is a position where the phone is out of the way from all of the screens. And yet it's still low enough that it doesn't block the windshield or the view of the road. Once I'm happy with where it is, I can lock the thumb nut. And now I can use one hand to put the phone in. I can also just adjust it ever so slightly to make it work for me. Lock this back down. And there we go. It's really easy to use this holder with one hand. Inside there are a pair of perfectly tuned springs. And the way they work is they grab your phone like you would with your hand, and it's really, really secure. It's really good for off-roading. It's actually designed for off-roading with off-roading in mind, and it's going to hold your phone on any terrain. Next, let's talk about some other options. We offer MagSafe equipped holders, both charging and non-charging versions. So this is a non-charging phone mount. What I've done is again, put it in the ball, put the ball in a socket. And now if I choose a position that works for me, and I have a MagSafe equipped phone, so all I gotta do is bring the phone straight to the holder and it just grabs it out of my hand and it keeps it there on any terrain as well. Of course, I can put it horizontally as well. It works in both of the holders that I showed. And it's really, really easy to use. So if you're more interested in the convenience of just every day in and out, then maybe the MagSafe is for you. The last choice we have is the MagSafe holder. It's actually the G2 holder that's backward compatible with MagSafe with a charging capability inside, right? So I already got my cable installed so I can plug it in the back. Again, let me choose a position that works for me. Tuck this cable a little bit out of the way. And there we go. Now I'm also not only getting the convenience of a magnet grabbing my phone out of my hand and keeping it there securely, but I'm also getting a nice steady charge. Well, I hope you found these installation instructions clear and this video useful. Thanks very much for watching.